In our thousands, in our millions, we are all Palestinians. Yeah, we're all Palestinians now. For a travesty for one is a travesty for all. Well, yeah, we're all Palestinians now. From the river to the sea, Palestinians must be free. Yeah, we're all Palestinians now. And so each and every day, we must all stand up and say, we are all Palestinians now. In our thousands, in our millions, we are all Palestinians. Yeah, we're all Palestinians now. For a travesty for one is a travesty for all. Yeah, we're all Palestinians now. Everybody! In our thousands, in our millions, we are all Palestinians. Yeah, we're all Palestinians now.
Mohamed Omari is a 17-year-old Palestinian student who was abducted by the Israeli occupation forces last month. In the early hours of the morning, on the 2nd of March 2016, Israeli occupation forces raided the Palestinian village of Abad near Jenin. They smashed Mohammed's parents' door down and surrounded the bedrooms where the family was sleeping. They shackled Mohammed and dragged him out at gunpoint. He was interrogated at Solemn Detention Center for 39 hours. They accused him of writing a post on Facebook against the occupation forces. The page they showed him wasn't his. He doesn't even have a Facebook account. With no evidence of even writing against the occupation, the military judge, ignoring Mohammed's age, just slapped an arbitrary administrative detention order against him, saying he's a security threat to the State of Israel. Administrative detention is a form of internment where Palestinians are caged indefinitely without charge or trial, without any way to defend themselves. Mohammed, who is still a child, has been locked up on an initial 3 months administrative order with possibility of the administrative order being extended indefinitely by further 3 month orders. Some prisoners have spent over a decade in extended administrative detention orders without charge or trial. Use of administrative detention in this manner is illegal under the 4th Geneva Convention and amounts to a war crime. This administrative order will mean Mohammed will miss his exams and will not be able to apply for university. Instead, he'll have to repeat the whole year again, assuming the administrative order is not extended further. Today, Mohammed is caged at Megiddo Prison in Israel, which is secured by the British security company G4S. G4S provides the central command room at Megiddo, from where the entire prison is controlled. That means we have in the UK have a direct responsibility to end these war crimes against Palestinian children like Mohammed. Please ask your local council, universities, banks and supermarkets not to use the services of G4S. Thank you. Drop G4S. Free the children! Free Palestine!
Free Palestine!
For a travesty for one is a travesty for all. Yeah, we're all Palestinians now. The guitar bit. From the Balfour Declaration to the Israeli occupation, yeah, we're all Palestinians now. Enforced colonization and the ethnic cleansing of a nation, yeah, we're all Palestinians now. In our thousands, in our millions, we are all Palestinians, yeah, we're all Palestinians now. For a travesty for one is a travesty for all. Yeah, we're all Palestinians now. From the river to the sea, Palestinians must be free. Yes, we're all Palestinians now. And so each and every day, we must all stand up and say, we are all Palestinians now. Everybody, in our thousands, in our millions, we are all Palestinians. Yeah, we're all Palestinians now. For a travesty for one is a travesty for all. Yes, we're all Palestinians now.
16 years old, Hamza Hamad is the youngest Palestinian to be held indefinitely without any charge, without any trial, with no way to defend himself. Hamza is simply being punished by Israel because his father is a resistance fighter from 13 years ago who had successfully ambushed an Israeli army unit which was invading his village in 2003. His father has written a book from prison which includes letters to his son Hamza. This has upset the military. Over the years, Hamza's family have endured the worst of the occupation. Their home has been demolished as punishment by the army. They suffer regular raids and family members are routinely arrested for no reason. The breadwinner of the family, Hamza's father, is permanently imprisoned and his family are refused the right to visit him in prison. Previously, last August, the army raided their home, destroying their computers and interrogated Hamza and his younger 10-year-old brother. Hamza was interrogated for 22 continuous days at Jerusalem's notorious Russian compound, infamous for torture. This time, in March 2016, the soldiers just came and dragged 16-year-old Hamza straight to Offa military prison without even the formality of any interrogation. They just slapped a 6-month renewable administrative detention order on him. Not even any accusation of him of any crime or formality of a trial. He was being punished for his father and his book. Hamza, who is still a child, has been locked up on an initial 6 months administrative order with possibility of administrative order being extended indefinitely by further detention orders. Some prisoners have spent over a decade in extended administrative detention orders without any charge or trial. Use of administrative detention in this manner is illegal under the Fourth Geneva Convention and amounts to a war crime. Today, Hamza is caged at Offa prison on the illegally occupied West Bank. Offa is secured by the British security company G4S. G4S provides the perimeter defence systems for the walls and the central command room at Orfa, from where the entire prison is controlled. This means that we in the United Kingdom have a direct responsibility to end these war crimes against Palestinian children like Hamza. Please ask your local council, universities, banks and supermarkets not to use the services of G4S. Thank you. Drop G4S! Drop G4S! Free the children!
Free the children!
Free Palestine!
One love, one land. Let's get together for Palestine. Hear the children crying. See the children dying.
One love.
Let's all cry out for Palestine. Right. Yeah, let's get together for Palestine. Hear the children crying.
One love.
See the children dying. Let's get together for Palestine. Yeah, let's all sing out for Palestine, 'cause you know it's right. Let's get together for Palestine, especially for Gaza. Yeah, let's get together for Palestine. Over this land, the mothers are screaming. And all over this land, Zion is scheming. In this land so full of sin, children of Palestine, we must unite and win. One love,
one land,
one land. Let's get together for Palestine, yeah. Let's get together and free Palestine, yeah. Let's get together and Palestine. Hear the children crying.
One
see the children dying.
One
let's get together and free Palestine. Yeah, let's all get together and free Palestine. Hear the children crying. See the children dying. Let's all get together and free Palestine. Let's get together and free Palestine. Let's get together and free Palestine. Yes.
Dima al-Wawi is a 12-year-old schoolgirl who was abducted on her way to school. On the fateful morning of the 9th of February 2016, she made breakfast for her younger sisters, tidied the house, and left for school. To get to school, she had to pass the illegal Israeli settlement of Karmei Dzur. Human rights groups have documented how Palestinian children are routinely attacked on their way to school by illegal Jewish settlers. As she approached to go past the settlement, they pounced on her accusing her of concealing a knife. She was made to lie in the dirt, face down at gunpoint, and occupation soldiers came and dragged her away. In contravention of international law, she was interrogated without the presence of her parents or a lawyer. She was caged, and her parents and her lawyer were still not allowed to see her. The Israeli prison service denied her even a change of clothes. So several weeks later, where her parents caught their first and last glimpse of her in military court, she was still wearing the same school uniform she had on when she was abducted. Israel's military courts have been described as an efficient production line to imprison Palestinians without any evidence. It has a conviction rate of 99.7%. Dima was found guilty and is currently caged at Israel's notorious Hasharon women's prison. At Hasharon, Palestinian women prisoners have to endure beatings, insults, threats, sexually explicit harassment, and sexual violence, and humiliation at the hands of Israeli guards. They are often forced to undergo degrading strip searches during the middle of the night, forced to squat naked and subjected to intrusive internal body searches for no other reason than as a punitive measure. Women have been beaten and left tied to their beds for a day and a half and not allowed to go to the toilet as punishment for spilling water. The cells at Hasharon prison are overcrowded, dirty, and infected with rodents and cockroaches. There is a total absence of basic hygiene. Women have even been denied sanitary pads when menstruating. The heat is unbearable. The windows are closed and covered, so hardly any air or daylight can enter. The food is insufficient and of inferior quality and dirty, often containing insects and worms. At times, there are not enough portions to go around. Dima's parents have not once been allowed to see their young daughter at Hasharon prison. Her mother, Mudia, says, after she was convicted and sent to prison, I felt a great loss. It is the first time I felt actual pain in my chest, losing my child and not being able to see her. Hasharon is secured by the British security company G4S. They provide the entire security system for the prison, including the central command room from where the whole prison is controlled. This means that we, in the UK, have a direct responsibility to end these crimes against Palestinian children like Dima. Please ask your local council, universities, banks and supermarkets not to use the services of G4S. Thank you. Drop G4S.
Drop G4S.
Free the children.
Free the children.
Free Palestine.
Palestinians, we are all Palestinians now. For a travesty for one is a travesty for all. Yeah, we're all Palestinians now. Yes, we're all Palestinians now.
Free!
Free.